think of the blockchain ecosystem, I think of kind of three primary areas. The first would be payment tokens. So that's like your Bitcoin, Ethereum. And the second would be utility tokens. I think of that like Filecoin, EOS. And the third is security tokens. And security tokens are just taking real world assets and placing them on the blockchain and providing liquidity to areas that have never had it before.
For me, what I see a security token is a merging of the terrestrial worlds and then this whole new internet economy that we have. And so these traditional financial structures of securities have existed for a long time, but now we're able to do it more efficiently. So a security token is a token that's backed by a hard asset, but it's a lot more liquid, and it's just, it allows more people to get involved in this economy.
The head of the SEC has indicated that he believes all tokens currently classify as being security tokens. That being said, a lot of startups are starting to respond to these signals by trying to make their tokens more compliant by performing strictly within those securities guidelines. So they're making tokens that have something like an equity component or pay off dividends to ensure sort of compliance with those securities regulations.
I'm afraid that the future will be, in this respect, will be regulated. And what we're looking for from regulators is to draw a clear line between what has to conform to the old laws, what maybe doesn't have to conform, and where we might look at new laws and new categories, not just regulators, because regulators have to enforce the laws on the books. So we really want to have a conversation with lawmakers about this new economy.
I think there's a massive problem going on with the US government and the whole regulatory regime. I mean, think about the turn of the 20th century, when people rode around on horses. And then cars came out. What would have happened if we regulated cars with the speed limits they had for horses? Or what happened if we had the construct of horses and we tried to regulate cars? Obviously that wouldn't work. So that's what's happening right now. This is a new type of digital asset. The regulatory regime has to change. And I wish that there would be a safe harbor area where people could operate without worrying about all this government BS right now.
I do think that what we learn from the SEC, say, over the next year is going to have an impact on what different ICOs look like. There may be room for something that looks more like a commodity token or a utility token, depending on what the SEC ends up saying.
I believe we will tokenize and trade almost everything. And to do that, we need a new playing field, a new framework for lawmakers to give us the ability to do that innovation.
From a regulation standpoint, I'm very pleased to see that at least in the US government, you're having positive conversations around it. The conversation is actually happening. I was at a panel this morning and they said that 2 years ago when they first heard about blockchain technology, they put their hands in their eyes and they said, I hope this goes away. Hasn't gone away, we're bigger than ever. So I see it developing as long as people like the Security Token Association, as long as the people in this room work together with government to make sure that regulation is written properly.
The US regulators seem to have a positive bent on the way they want to go. Obviously, we want to eliminate all the hashtag Lambo instances and focus on real value creation. So we're in this gray area and in this transition stage, and it's a perfect time for people who missed last year to start learning about the new standards, the new protocols, the new platforms that are going to lead the way on the next big boom, which is going to be much bigger.
The laws around securities were designed to prevent fraud. And we saw a bunch of fraud in the ICO space, and that's a lot harder to do with a security issuance because the penalties are very real and very large. So because of that, the protections are there. It's also a framework that we're already familiar with. We already have investment banks, we already have ATSs, all those things exist. The tax implication of issuing a security, of issuing debt, and so on, are known.
KYC, Know Your Client, and AML, anti-money laundering regulations, impose rules about who, or knowing the identity of who is trading securities. So these are important, particularly for markets and exchanges to ensure compliance, but they're also important for startups to know about to make sure that they're following whatever the regulatory regime is. Security tokens, many of them are aiming to make a market more liquid than the current sort of establishment version of that market looks. So you see sometimes examples in real estate where maybe an asset like a building could be tokenized, allowing for shares to be traded in that piece of real estate more easily than they would have been otherwise.
As the industry matures, we start to realize that pretty much everything is a security. The statements coming out of the SEC have been careful, but pointing to that end.
I think in the blockchain ecosystem right now, security tokens are really like the smallest area, right? So we have utility tokens, and certainly payment tokens is a big area, and I think we're going to see a big shift. There's a real world use case today to ship these assets onto the blockchain. The technology exists. I think we're going to see a big movement as real estate investors, venture capital investors, and private equity investors move toward security tokens.
Today's ICO market is going to be a relic of the past soon, because probably 50% of all token fundraisers should be done with equity tokens. Equity tokens are the right tool for the job if you're raising money for a startup. An ICO is really today for a utility token is really project finance. It's not company finance. If you're doing company finance, you don't want a utility token. You want an equity token, and that's a security.
The big ICOs of this year, if you look at the numbers that have been happening, Telegram was obviously huge. That was a securities offering done as a Reg D offering. Filecoin, $250 million, done as a securities offering, and many, many more like that. It's becoming more and more of a trend. Whether the token itself is a security or not, people are being careful and selling them as such.
The main benefits are right now that they give you more comfort as an investor that you're not going to be told that you're holding something illegal from the government of the United States. So the US government is taking advantage of the position they've held historically in the capital markets to try and dictate how securities are placed and how capital is formed. I honestly don't think the United States has the ability to hold this position much longer. And unless we get our act together and start to have real rules and a real process, I think you're going to see this whole business flow offshore to Europe, Asia, and Russia.
In order to trade in securities, you need to be an exchange or an ATS in the United States. Some people have gone around that by going to other jurisdictions, and that might work for a while. Here in the US, we don't really have any exchanges that are trading security tokens today.
No doubt there will be security token ICOs, and they will get larger and larger. But as of today, the beginning of May 2018, there are no live security token platforms, and there's no liquidity. So until those markets develop and a couple of these things get lit up, then there's not going to be a really robust market.
I think that many startups are thinking about tokenizing assets in order to increase liquidity. That's a very important growing area for security tokens. But it's definitely possible, again, depending on what the regulation evolves to be over the next year, that we'll see more initial issuances of these security tokens.
Tokenization is liquidity. So we have a capital market system that's broken. There's been more ICOs in the last 6 months than there's been IPOs in the last 20 years. So if you wanted to invest in new, growing, exciting businesses, you gotta do tokens. So tokens represent liquidity, they represent entrepreneurship, they represent opportunity. I think that you're going to see everything's going to tokenize. There's no reason to have a paper certificate when you can have a live piece of digital media that you can trade actively.
Liquidity is just where there are a large number of buyers and sellers. And typically that means that you could trade to some significant value without deteriorating the price or making the price of a security go up dramatically.